talking to me?
No,
okay.
Actually, I know about the direct family of
this website is going to promote what is it?
So it's a
competition organized by Global School Network.org, like it's an organization, and organizing local literacy competitions. In this, we have 8 categories, mainly like safety and security,
good. I wish you all the best.
Innovation, some new things we find, or many. And they found about the surgical treatment that we do for Parkinson's disease. And they came here and they did a fantastic job. We do a treatment for deep brain stimulation for Parkinson's disease. Cancer is next generation treatment, but deep brain stimulation is the current therapy. And we have been the pioneers in that. So they came here and they studied everything. Obviously they are medical students, so they have a little more knowledge and in-depth understanding of the disease. And they made a beautiful video and a PowerPoint presentation incorporating many data and also a little bit of graphics and many other aspects, made it a little more dramatic. And then they presented it and they won the second prize. And it was an inter-college competition for the best project. So I wish you all the best. I think what is the structure of this website? It's only going to depend on what aspect we are taking, different diseases, different people. How are you looking at
it? Sir, we have just started it from January and we have to complete it in May. So we are making surveys and interviews. We have just started. This is the first time we are doing an interview.
Okay.
So for this website.
We have to make surveys, interviews, and we have to collect information on these, and we have to make surveys.
What I would recommend strongly is that you think about the Indian scenario.
Yeah.
Because you talk about the Indian scenario, it's not no point in talking about the global scenario. And the aspect that you have to highlight, and I think you can take a step further also, if you've got the project to go up to May.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So, but the website has to be up and running by 29th, or you just have to submit the outline?
So first we have to submit the outline till March, and then we have to fully submit the whole website.
So you pick down these points. These are the points that you should look into the website and you should consider taking them. The point is basic information about stem cells. You want the paper, proper paper tissue.
No, sir.
And you want to take a chair, you want to sit here?
No sir, it's fine.
You okay?
Yes.
So first of all, you have to collect the and make the information, basic information about stem cells. Then the role, present role of stem cells in medical disorders, which is an established treatment. And it is in hematological disorders, blood malignancies. It has been used for last 10 years. So you can talk about that. And then if you want, you can talk to Dr. Basade. I'll introduce you to him. So you can talk and get some information. Also, you can write down, get some homework done on the net and find out. So, what is stem cells? What are the different types of stem cells? That will cover everything. Where do you get the stem cells from? What is the word stem cell meaning? Why we call it stem cell? Basically, I don't know whether you read about it or not. So the stem cells are pluripotent cells. There are three levels of potency. What is a pluripotent? Second is multipotent cells, third is the final destination cells. So pluripotent cells are the cells that can divide into any areas. They can multiply, they can grow into any areas. So this details, you will get it from the net. You just understand the concept and structure of how to design the thing.
So I got to go through this and all these three in the Wikipedia.
That's right. Yes. So that's what I'm saying. From the net, you guys are very smart now. You can get more information than anyone else. But most important about information is it's a double-edged sword. Why do we need teachers then? Well, we shouldn't need teachers. We could just go and type in the net. The problem is that the information that you get from the net is not a pure information. It's a confounding source. So you've got to know how to filter that, how to utilize that, how to put it in the perspective. Second important aspect about it, it doesn't give you the experience. The experience which the teacher has, you've never come through a net. Many patients come to me, they bring 5 pages of documents of reading about a disease, and they try to show that they might be doing something, they might do more, a little more than me also in a particular disease. That's not an important thing. But how to interpret that information, when to use it, what to use it, what are the repercussions, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages, how authentic that information is. All that patients will never come to you. So the job of your website, you should have a mission. You should say,